Brand new antibody testing out of New York State shows a staggering 25% of New York City residents testing positive for antibodies. So what does that mean for preparations to reopen? Joining us now is Corey Johnson. He is the Speaker of the New York City Council. Mr. Speaker, thanks so much for being with us. Happy birthday, I understand, this morning as well. Have you been tested?
Thank you. Good morning.
Have you been tested for antibodies? Okay.
I have not been tested. No, I have been, self-isolating and practicing physical distance at my boyfriend's apartment during the last 6 weeks or so. I haven't been tested, but you've been talking about it. We're really going to need to ramp up tests here in New York City as people start to talk about how to potentially reopen down the line.
What is this 25% of people testing positive for antibodies in New York City? What does that mean to you as you craft public policy? How does that inform your decisions?
Well, I'll say, of course, I'm not an epidemiologist, so I don't want to pretend like I have all the expertise. And you heard Dr. Sanjay Gupta talk about the tests earlier in that many of the tests may not be the most accurate tests, and the testing is very, very sensitive. But we do know what is clear from that data and from other data that we've looked at. We do know that there was widespread community transmission in New York City before we realized it. A lot more people were getting infected before it actually started to show up. When you look at some of those public health numbers, there are numbers that are called the ILI numbers, influenza-like illness numbers, that are tracked every single winter. And you saw a spike in those numbers before coronavirus started to show up in an apparent way, and it's likely that it was those coronavirus illnesses that people were getting sick with. So we know it's widespread, and we knew it was widespread before.
Should you have been preparing earlier then?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, I've said this before, you know, everyone was too slow. In the midst of an epidemic and a pandemic, speed is everything. And, you know, I called for some of the things earlier than others, like closing schools and banning large gatherings, but none of us were fast enough. And part of the reason why it was so difficult is we were basically in a dark room without being able to turn the light on. We had a little tiny flashlight without the testing to understand what was happening in New York City at the time. So we need to take those lessons.
Let me ask you about some developments over the last 24 hours. You are part of a push to open New York City streets, many miles and miles and miles of New York City streets, close them to traffic and open them to pedestrians. Why?
Because as the weather gets nice and it's a beautiful day here today in New York City, you're seeing more and more New Yorkers who want to go outside and exercise. When you have children who aren't going to be in school this summer, and with playgrounds closed and with beaches likely not open at capacity and public pools not open, you need to find places where New Yorkers can actually get outside in a socially distanced way. Right now in New York City, as you know, John, we have parks across neighborhoods, but in many of those parks, things are really crammed right now, and it's creating anxiety. So we have a lot of streets. We crafted a deal to open up 100 miles of city streets to allow people to run and walk and have children be on their bikes in a way that is safe, and you don't have people crammed into parks. As the weather gets nicer, as the summer comes, we're going to need this more than ever as more people go outside. And this is a great way to do it. Paris has done it. Milan has done it. Oakland has done it. Minneapolis has done it. And now New York City is going
to
do it.
I guess what you have to avoid are the pictures like we're seeing out of California right now. You're talking about streets, not beaches. But we've seen these pictures of beaches with people over the weekend. You know, it doesn't look like they're really social distancing quite to the extent that they should be. Let me ask you quickly, Speaker. President Trump yesterday twice asked governors about whether or not it was appropriate to start opening the schools in their states. Now, most states have actually announced they're going to close schools for the rest of the year. New York State has not made that decision yet. Do you see any possibility of schools reopening here?
I think it's unlikely. I think that, you know, to make a decision like that, we would need to be doing a lot more of the testing that you've talked about in this hour that we're not able to do right now without the federal coordination. So this has been very hard for parents, very hard for children. We need to make sure we're on a course to hopefully get the schools reopened up back in September.
Mr. Speaker, Cory Johnson, thank you very much for being with us. As we said, we hope you have a happy birthday. These birthdays during the pandemic, memorable, to say the least.
Thank you, John. And I just want to say, end with, it's important to have hope. A lot of New Yorkers are feeling worried and scared at this time. We got through the fiscal crisis of the 1970s. We got through 9/11. We got through the Great Recession. We got through Hurricane Sandy. We can get through this if we're unified and smart and strategic, and that's what we need to do. So thank you for all your coverage. And New York City, we'll get through this if we do it together. Thanks, John.
We appreciate you being with us this morning. So some restaurants in the United States making